When the blue of the night meets the gold of the day.
Get the guitar right in there, Perry. Let's hear it. Now take off the boxing gloves and let's hear it. Better.
Kraft Music Hall with John Scott Trotter, his orchestra and chorus, Eddie Duchin, the charioteers, and Bing's special guests, the lovely songstress Peggy Lee, and that racetrack man, the bookmaker's pinup boy, Joe Frisco.
Yes, yes.
And here's Bing with a slice of shoe fly pie.
Fly pie and apple pan dowdy, it makes your eyes bug out, your tummy say howdy. Shoe fly pie and apple pan dowdy, I never get enough of that wonderful stuff. Shoe fly pie and apple pan dowdy, makes the sun come out when the heavens are cloudy. Shoe fly pie and apple pan dowdy, I never get enough of that wonderful stuff. Mama, when you bake, Mama, cancel my cake, Mama. For heaven's sake, go to the oven and make some ever-loving shoe fly pie. An apple pan dowdy makes your eyes bug out, your tummy say howdy. Shoe fly pie and apple pan dowdy, I never get enough of that wonderful stuff. I do not want cake,
Mama,
for my sake.
Go to the oven,
light up some ever-loving shoe fly pie. An apple pan dowdy makes your eyes bug out, your tummy say howdy. Shoe fly pie, an apple pan dowdy, I never get enough of that wonderful stuff.
Shoe fly pie, an apple pan dowdy, shoe fly pie, an apple pan dowdy, shoe fly pie, an apple pan dowdy.
I never get enough of that wonderful stuff.
Wonderful stuff on the cuff.
Excellent, Bing, excellent. And by the way, congratulations on your birthday.
Oh, that's right. This is my birthday, isn't it?
Yeah, just what is your age, old-timer? Telling me?
Well, you'll have to check with Brother Everett on that. He takes care of that type of thing for me. And you, Eddie Duchin, no cracks, please.
Okay, next cracking. You know, Bing, right after the program, we're going to have a big birthday cake.
Chocolate, huh?
No.
Angel food?
No.
What kind of cake is it?
Cheesecake.
Oh, my. I should have known. I'm not going to knock it either.
Yes, Bing, it's a beautiful cheesecake with just oodles of candles on it.
Lots of candles, huh?
Sure.
Well, ce soir, je suis un petit fatigué.
Eh?
That's tired for you squares. Could you order up a hurricane to help me blow the candles out?
I'll borrow the wind machine from the sound.
You'll need them. All them candles. Good. And now, Eddie Duchin, do you have a piano tune to blow our listeners away?
Yes, I'd like to do a George Gershwin medley of The Man I Love and Someone to Watch Over Me.
Well, I'd certainly like to hear the same, Eddie. Just fan your fanny to the piano and waft that melody over this way. was great, Eddie. My sprouts are listening. Why don't you practice? Our friends, the Charioteers, appear now with one of their finest spirituals, Home in That Rock, which they'll sing right after this attenuated oration.
We're all asked by our government not to waste a single slice of bread, so hang on to those last few slices from the loaf, even if they do get a little bit dry. Spread them generously with a creamy Kraft cheese spread, and they'll taste swell. Or toast them for grand sandwiches with thick fillings of delicious Kraft spreads. For instance, take Kraft pimento cheese spread, so creamy, rich tasting with the bits of scarlet pimento all through it. That's all the spread your sandwiches need, and that, Mother, is a help you'll certainly recognize these days. Remember, Kraft pimento is just one of seven delicious cheese spreads that Kraft gives you. Get acquainted with the whole wonderful assortment so you can pick out your family's special favorites. Look for them tomorrow at your food store, the handy, delicious Kraft cheese spreads.
I got a home in that rock. Don't you see? Don't you see? I got a home.
Done, man. Nicely done. That song from Road to Utopia still haunts me, Little John. Shall we haunt the folks with it? You think that money is everything, and yet it's anybody's spring. Go make a fortune, become a king, and still it's anybody's spring. And if you flash a bankroll, do you suppose the brook would care, or that a rose would say, there goes a millionaire? It's more than diamonds around a ring, because it's anybody's spring. You may be born with a silver spoon, and yet it's anybody's moon. You couldn't buy a ticket to hear the first robin sing. It's free because it's anybody's spring. A very handy little lady with any kind of a tune is our guest this evening. A highly personable, attractive young lady who's been hitting the jackpot with her recordings in just about every jukebox in the land. And here she is, Miss Peggy Lee.
Good evening, Bing.
How are you, Peg?
I didn't know it was your birthday, Bing. I would have brought you a bag of gumdrops or something.
Well, I'll take a rain check on the gumdrops, Peggy, but if you've got a song on you, I'll settle for that.
All right, Bing. How about I Don't Know Enough About You?
Sounds clever. You wrote this song, didn't you, Peggy?
Mm-hmm.
A lot of others. Well, lay it right in there.
I know a little bit about a lot of to sing, but I don't know enough about you. Just when I think you're mine, you try a different line. And baby, what can I do? I read the latest news, no buttons on my shoes. But baby, I'm confused about you. You get me in a spin, oh, what a stew I'm in. 'Cause I don't know enough about you. Jack of all trades, master of none. And isn't it a shame? I'm so sure that you'd be good for me if you'd only play my game. You know I went to school, and I'm nobody's fool. That is to say, until I met you, I know a little bit about a lot of things, but I don't know enough about you. I know a little bit about biology and a little more about psychology. I'm a little dim in geology, but I don't know enough about you. I guess I'd better get out the encyclopedia and brush up on some schmur to schmooze. 'Cause I don't know enough about you.
That is worth the money, This being Derby Week, it seemed incumbent upon us, Kentucky Derby being held next Saturday, we ought to produce an eminent authority on the turf, on horse racing. A fellow that uses a racing form for a pup tent, Mr. Joe Frisco. Welcome to the Old Kraft Music Hall, Joe Frisco. Tell me, are you here through the courtesy of the racetrack?
No, Bing, I'm here through the courtesy of my creditors.
Ah, they tell me you're a good horse player.
I was a good horse player until I started to play your horses.
What happened?
Lost my wife, home, and family, and everything.
Well, your troubles are over now, Joe. I got good news for you. Move in. I sold my horses.
Your trouble is all over. My trouble has just started. I've got the habit now.
Yeah?
But I'm going to the doctor that cures you from the races.
You taking a cure?
Yeah.
Well, I ought to go to him, too. Where's this doctor's office?
Doctor's office is about a mile and an eighth from here.
You couldn't make that a mile and 3/16, could you?
The doctor's a pretty old man. I don't think he can go that far.
What does the doctor do for you? What's his routine?
Well, he asks your earning capacity, how many in your family, who you support.
Yeah. Use medicine?
Don't use no medicine, no. He only works on the mind. He's what they call a...
Psychiatrist?
No, this guy's a Swede, a tall Swede.
What does he do for you? Does he take you off of him right away? Does he make you stop betting the horses right away? Or does he sort of...
Put you on a diet, like.
Oh, a diet, huh?
Day, that's for 3 weeks.
Did you have any trouble getting him to take you as a patient?
Well, he didn't want to take me as a client at
all. He didn't? Why not?
No, he asked me how long I played him. I lied to him. I played him 30 years. I told him 20.
Oh, Joe.
I heard him say to the girl in his side room, he said, I got a mental case out here.
Mental case? How did you know he meant you?
I was the only one in the room. It wasn't an entry.
What else does doctor do for you? What does he do?
He gave me a bottle of penicillin.
What's it?
Penicillin.
No penicillin. That's well, what did he give you that for?
They use it in the army.
Yeah.
It's for the nerves.
Yeah?
For the nerves, yeah.
What do they do? How do they make it? It's
made out of mold. Moldy bread and moldy meat. Not molehill.
No.
The mountain's made out of
that. Anything that's moldy, huh?
Quite the nerves.
Well, they could make it out of one of Hope's old pictures, then, I guess.
Easy. Yeah. He can make it out of one of his new ones.
I don't want that. I'm in one of his new ones. Makes cracking. Well, what else does doctor do for you, Joe?
Double dose, huh?
Yeah, what else does doctor do for you?
Well, he gives you a wooden box, the little box.
Wooden blocks,
huh? The school kid.
Is that so?
There's no numbers on the block.
No numbers on the block?
It's a 12-story building.
You got to build a building. Oh, man.
And then he gives you his photograph.
Photograph of the doctor?
That's to keep your mind on him. You lay the photograph home on your bird's eye furniture. I don't know what
you're saying. Bird's eye? No, I've got a bird's eye furniture. I got early California.
Well, I've got late Wisconsin.
Well, what does he do? Does he get you, how far do you go with this building?
Well, if he can get you up to the third or fourth story inside of 3 months, he'll get you off the horses.
Get you to lay off betting on horses?
He'll get you off.
How long have you been going to him?
5 months now.
How high are you up on the building?
I'm in the basement. I can't...
Well, you can't get out of the basement, huh?
No.
You been out the track at all?
I went out the track one day.
What day was that?
Well, I snuck away one day. That's the day the big race.
Seabiscuit. Boy, you had to see the mighty Seabiscuit.
60,000 people there.
Big crowd, huh?
Everybody was yelling and hollering. Mm-hmm. I couldn't see nothing. The guy in front of me with the Panama hat was yelling. I turned him around, and who do you think it was? The doctor with my money.
Do you ever have any dreams about the horses, Joe?
Yeah, I dream all the time.
I dream about the horses. I dreamt the other night there were six horses jumped right over my bed.
Oh, those are hurdle races. I don't play them.
I'm sure glad to have you on the program tonight, Joe.
Yeah, you needed me.
Listen, let's break this off so quick. Someday I'll pick you up with my car. We'll have a little lunch, huh?
Tomorrow?
No, I can't go tomorrow. I'm with the Elks Club. I can't pick you up tomorrow.
I ain't doing nothing Tuesday.
Well, I can't pick you up Tuesday. I have to go to the studio.
How about Thursday?
No, I'm playing golf. Can't pick you up.
Well, you figure that yourself, sir.
Okay.
I'm around.
Well, look out for that first step when you go out now, will you? You all right, Frisco?
You can pick me up now, Bing.
Thank you, Joe Frisco. You know, I'll get that doctor's address. I want to... Victor Young, Paramount's musical director and a conductor of renown for 20 years, wrote a song some time ago which Eddie Duchin and I would like to transcribe for you tonight, begging your indulgence. Are you ready, Edward?
Beautiful love, you're all a mystery. Beautiful love, what have you done to me? I was contented till you came along, thrilling my soul with your song. Beautiful love, I've roamed your paradise, searching for love, my dream to realize, reaching for heaven, depending on you. Beautiful love, will my dreams come true? For love, my dream to realize, reaching for heaven, depending on you. Beautiful love, well, my dream come true.
Thank you, Eddie. Thank you very much for the assist. From Beautiful Love, we turn to one of the late Jerome Kern's last and most beautiful ballads all through the day. But first, here is a man with something very important.
Right now, we here in America are the best-fed people in the world, while millions of men and women and little children in Europe and Asia are hungry, facing actual starvation. It's up to us, who have so much, to help in this crisis. We can share a meal and save a life. But how, you may ask? Well, here's how you can help every day. Buy only as much bread and other wheat products as you really need. Use rice, fats, and oils sparingly. Eliminate all food waste. Turn in your used fats at the food store. Plant a garden. Raise as much of your family's food as you can.
And above all, remember that you're saving food for folks who desperately need it when you buy less. When you use up those leftovers,
the
none of us can turn a hungry child away from our door. So let's not waste a bit of food to keep that child alive.
From now until July 1st, a great battle with hunger is raging around the world. Do your part to help win it. Let's all share our abundance with the hungry.
Birthday, big boy.
Thank you, Bob.
This is Bob. I had to go to the wax museum to find enough candles for this cake. Hope.
There you are, old boy.
Oh,
there you are.
A brilliant thing. Wait a minute. I have a poem.
I'll never get you out of the pool.
I have to get this hat back to Max Sennett in 20 minutes. Look. And I have one little poem I just want to throw in here with that cake. Isn't that a beautiful thing?
Oh, my heavens.
This is the hottest audience you've had this week. Look. Here's my poem. I just want to say happy birthday to you, Flab.
Yeah?
I know the age, but I won't blab. I just want to say happy birthday, Pop.
Thank
Here's
you.
Your cake with the cheese in the middle and the Pepsodent on top. Thank you. Happy birthday. Give me a key. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. 79.
Happy birthday.
Later.
All through the day I dream about tonight.
Get that cake out of here. It'll knock all the fire extinguishers. Down my cake.
All through the day I dream about my cake. Until the time when I'm here with you. Down falls the sun.
The song of the cake.
Where am I? Just a minute.
The evening mist melts away. Down smiles the moon. And soon your lips recall the kiss I dreamed of all through the
cures all the hatches for tonight. We'll be back next Thursday to help celebrate with all the Derby winners. Good night, everybody, and thank you, Rob, for bringing that happy piece of suicide pie.
In guests next week, Garth Eclair and Spike Jones and the City Slickers. Good night, everybody.
And now here's another Kraft quality food product that's sure to add zest to your meals and lunches. It's Kraft salad mustard, tempting golden salad mustard, prepared to Kraft's own special recipe. You can use creamy Kraft salad mustard in all sorts of appetizing ways, blended zestfully into cooked dishes, fondues, and Welsh rabbits, or as a tasty spread for sandwich meats. And, of course, there's another variety for sharper tastes, the popular Kraft mustard with snappy horseradish added. Look for and buy both of these delicious Kraft mustards in your food store tomorrow.
This is NBC, the National Broadcasting Company.